Hi friends, welcome back to MuthStack. I'm your friend Ashish Pathy, MuthStack Architect. In today's session, we are going to explore the AnyPoint Data Graph data service, which is newly added to our AnyPoint platform with a real use case. So let's say I have a requirement where on my website, I wanted to display a book information as well as the author information. And this information is coming from the different APIs. So you can see left side, I have one API, REST API, which is giving me book information, and another API is giving me author information. So for simplicity, I just listed down few columns, but in actual scenario, there'd be huge data over here. So if we take the REST API approach for this requirement, I need to call these REST APIs, backend REST APIs, and I'll be having a experience API over here. That experience API, what it does, it just filters the data from these two backend API responses, and based on the requirement to display over here. Okay. But in future, if I get one more requirement where the number of columns are different, then again I need to write the separate experience API calling the same set of REST APIs. Okay, that is one concern. And I need to maintain the multiple experience API when that maintenance part comes into picture. So now we have a new data service added to our AnyPoint platform, which is AnyPoint Data Graph. So AnyPoint Data Graph internally or in the backend, it uses a GraphQL. So then question comes, what is GraphQL? So what it does is it takes the schema from your REST API and generates the unified schema. Okay. And from that schema, based on the query. So for example, here I need a book object where I need title and author information and the ISBN. So when it generates the unified schema, it checks whether is there any common column between these two responses. Okay, so we could see there is an author ID over here and author ID over here. Based on this column, it combines the response and generates the unified schema. Okay, and from that unified schema, we can filter out whenever there is a requirement, any requirement, you just need to write a GraphQL query. Based on that query, you'll get the result. So let's see the demo part quickly, how it so. For this part, this experience UI, behavior, we don't need to write any code. Okay. So the data graph will take care of handling that experience REST API part. Okay. We don't need to write any code. Okay. Let's jump onto the demo part. So let me go to my AnyPoint Studio. So you can see, you need to create a new account over here, trial account. If you have old account, this data graph won't be visible there. So you need to create a new account, new trial account, and then you'll be able to see here. Okay. So before jump to this data graph, so I have created two API specification for one for the books API and one for the REST API. Okay. Author REST API. So let's jump onto the design center. So I have author REST API, which will be written in this information. And the second one I have is the book REST API, which will be returning me this information. Okay. So I have designed it and have published it to the exchange. So let's see what data we have. So if you see the book, data type, I have ISBN, title, and author ID. Okay. And if I go back and I have a books. And I have two resources here, books and books with the URL parent. Okay, so you can see it here. Books returns the array of records, and with the URL parent, we are getting single record. Okay, let me show you quickly the authors API and data type also. Then we'll jump on to the data graph. So you can see here, I have author ID, I have name of the author, and the ISBN. Okay, so these two data types are linked with two columns. one is author ID and one is ISB. Okay. So what I did is I have just published it to the exchange. So let's check into the exchange. So let me go to the exchange and I'll show you. So I have this author API. I have this author REST API over here and book REST API. Okay, that's it. Then we'll jump on to the, so if you want to see the output of this author's API, you can use the, we are going to use the mock service only. So if I say 123 over here, you'll be able to see the output. Okay, same thing with the book REST API. So if I go here, you can see the mock data over here. Okay, now let's jump on to the demo part of the our data graph. So design part is over. Now we are going to use the mock service for both the APIs, and now we are going to generate the unified schema. Okay, so I already explained what is that unified schema. So unified schema will be generated based on the common ID. Okay, so I have author ID here and author ID over here. So we'll connect book with author based on author ID. We'll connect author with the book based on the ISBN column. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. Let me jump onto the data graph. So first we'll add the book API. So you can see that whatever you publish to the any point exchange, those APIs will be visible over here. Okay, so let's start with the book. So let's configure this. So I have an asset version 1.0.2 and API version v1. Confirm the selection. And this URL is automatically coming from the exchange for the mocking service. So just keep as it is. We have not given any authentication, so we'll select no auth. Let's preview the schema. Okay, so you can see there were two resources, books and books by ISBN. Okay, so let's say edit schema. How simple it is. We are not writing single line of code. Okay, so that's we need to. So let's add this to it. Let's check this guy. So we don't have any other resource right now, so we won't be able to, so you can see there is no resource target available. So once we add the author API, we'll be able to see that over here. Okay, so enable collaboration. We'll say that this is my primary ID for the books. So you need to select that column over here. Okay, so this will be my primary column. So with this column, we'll connect the author. Okay, so let's go ahead and say confirm. Okay, then we'll say add this guy to the unified schema. So now unified schema will be generated for the books only. Okay, so proceed to unified schema. Now let's wait for this. It will be this status will get changed to the up to date. So till that, I'll just pause this video. It is still updating the unified schema, but meanwhile we can see that for the book there are three columns available. Okay, so these are the fields and ISBN is the primary key. So now you can see that it's updated. So unified schema is ready for the books API. Okay, now we'll add the author API. Okay, so let's select this, go to next, configure URL. And I have 1.0.4 version of this asset and the API version is v1. So confirm selection. And you can see that it's reflecting in the mocking service also, 1.0.4. So we don't have any authentication on this API. To view the schema. Okay, now we'll edit this schema. What we are going to do is, so let's say this is the response. We are going to enable the collaboration. So we are saying for this resource, the primary ID will be author ID. Okay. Confirm. So now we have author ID, primary key in our author's REST API, and ISBN primary key in the book's API. Okay. So now let's try to connect these two guys. So everything is configuration. Okay. So now if you see here, for author, our target will be book, right? And what you are going to connect from author, for author, primary key is the author ID. For book, this will become foreign key. Okay, so save the changes. You will see one more, field added over here. So this is a link field, which is showing the book. So with this author, now book is linked. Okay, so let's say add to unified scheme. So from author, we have connected to the book. We have not connected from book to author. Okay, so we'll see that also. So let's wait for this to get updated. Okay. So let's do that also. So you need to go to the list of API added. You need to go to the book REST API. You need to go to this guy. We already enabled the collaboration. So link to another type. Here we'll find author now. And now with this guy, we'll be connecting with the ISV. Save these changes. Apply the changes. Okay. So it will take time to update this unified schema. Meanwhile, we'll just see how to run the now. So we have connected book with author and author with book. It's a different column. Okay. And then to run the query, you need to create application. So I have already created. So once you create that application, you will land on this page where you'll be writing your GraphQL queries. So let's see whether we are able to achieve what we have seen on the slide bar. So let me start with this empty. Now you just say press, control plus space bar. You'll be able to see what you can achieve it here. So you can select books. Okay. Go over here. You just select, control plus space bar. You'll be able to see the options. Now, based on your requirement, whether you need only ISBN and title, okay, run the query. Yeah, you can see here. Now I don't want only ISBN and title. I want author ID also. So you can go ahead and you can add the author ID also. So I'm not changing my URL over here. Okay, so if you see, we'll see that also. You can see this is the URL. This will be common. We are just changing this query, okay, GraphQL query. So yeah, so same URL be used. So only single URL at experience side will be exposing this URL, and based on the user requirement, they will just change the GraphQL. Okay, close it. So now let's go whether my unified schema is not updated from book, author is not connected yet. That's the reason we are not able to see that author object over here. Okay. Now let me go and change this and say, so unified schema is not yet updated. Let's see now here. This is, I need, so see here, automatically we are getting suggestions. So book by ISBN, it's asking for URI parameter. So we'll pass some URI parameter over here. And let me copy this. Just a second. Custom string. Okay. So over here also it's not updated. So right now we are able to see only single objects. We have not connected it. So once this unified schema is updated, we'll be able to see those connections also. Okay, so from book there will be author, from author there will be book. Okay, so here also you can say ISBN and your title. Okay, run this query, you'll be able to see the book's detail. Now I'm just pausing till this unified schema gets updated. Once we get the up to date mark here, we'll be able to query for the author. Now you can see that the unified schema is up to date. Now we can see here, we can see authors, books, and inside authors will be able to see the with those its own attribute we can see book also. Okay, so let's select this name. So this is a link object. From here we can take the title, we can take the ISBN. Run this query with a single endpoint and with a single query, we are able to achieve our requirement. And this data, if you see, the author data is coming from the author API and the book data is coming from the book API, and we have not written in a single line of code. Okay, so that's how we will be coming with more videos on this. Right now it's a very simple use case where I have shown that we have two REST APIs and we have connected using GraphQL with the AnyPoint data graph. Okay, so thank you for watching this. Please hit the like button and then share with the friends. Thank you.